Okay, unboxing the Bose Smart Soundbar 600. I think this is my first ever unboxing video, so you'll have to forgive the not very professional setup. So here we have the box, which I haven't opened yet, although I have prepared earlier the sellotape by slitting at the scissors. So here we go, let's see what we've got. Another box, that's kind of what I expected. Right, let's see you. Come on out. Bose soundbar, smart soundbar, 600. And this is where I realise I need the scissors again. No, actually it's got clever little thingies. I don't need the scissors. Good. This is what it's meant to look like. I hope it's not too big because it needs to fit in front of my TV. Okay, here we go. Okay, it's not that big. It's quite big. Quite nice looking. Very simple, just like a bar, which is what you would expect, just a sort of black bar. So supposedly this can make really good audio quality and I'll actually be able to hear what people are saying in films. But I'll have to connect it up to the TV first. Looks like it's got little smart controls here. And then on the back, we've got HDMI, which is what you would expect. Also like separate bass and so on, probably to connect it to other sound systems. It's got its little USB, mini USB power thingy, optical cable, but I don't have one of those anyway. But it all seems fairly straightforward. I'm hoping it also has instructions. I suspect it does in here somewhere. So, yeah, here we go. So we've got the cables that we need for it. So that is the optical audio. Don't know how you get optical audio. I'm not a tech person in that way. Power cord, techie enough to know what that does. Here is the HDMI. I have an HDMI cable, but you can never have too many. I've got loads of HDMI inputs on the back of that TV. And then here's the instructions, I think. Oh, safety instructions that nobody reads. It's basically just don't set it on fire, isn't it? Yeah, don't set it on fire. That's fine. I'm not going to set it on fire. Here's the little doofer, little remote control. So we've got our on-off Bluetooth, that's presumably input, play, don't know what the music thing is. Anyway, that's what the instructions are for. And lots of languages. Okay, I need an app. That's slightly annoying, actually. I don't like it where you have to have an app just to do one single thing. Hopefully I can delete that after I've done the setup. Right, 1 to 3 feet away from other wireless equipment. What other wireless equipment do I have? Ooh, I have the Fire Stick. No, that's not wireless. Is that wireless? Plugs into the TV. But then 0.3 meters is not too bad. So I'll try and keep it 30 centimeters away from that if I can. Okay, there's not many instructions. So we're going to have to leave it at this point, and I'm going to have to go and try and set it up. Okay, here's the soundbar in front of the TV, where, you know, it fits in very well with all the shiny black things. But the other slightly annoying thing that I've discovered so far is, look at the power cord. It's a 2-pin. So fortunately, I had this universal adapter thing in a drawer, which is lucky, but if you didn't, that would mean a trip to the shop or ordering something online before you could actually use it. I've looked in the box and I can't find anything to adapt it to UK plugs, UK sockets, but when you plug it in, the little light does go on and it has a bit of a think about it. This is the second time I've done this, and I thought I'd record it because it makes quite a nice noise, quite an impressive noise when it finally gets all connected up. that's quite an impressive, slightly spaceship landing sci-fi sound. It had some good deep bass on it. Bodes well, I think, for the future. So once I've got it set up with the app, we're going to try it out with a few music and programs and things. Okay, so I now have got the bar all set up, all plugged in, and the wires. Now, it was not easy to do. Turns out I need an optical wire, which was supplied, because the HDMI doesn't have the right input in the TV. But yeah, it took me a long time to get to the point where it told me that I needed to use the optical wire, because first of all, I had to use the app to set it up, and the app was like updating and try again and try restarting, and it took ages and lots of restarts and shutting down the app. But anyway, eventually got it working, and that's the only way you can find out which wire you're supposed to use. So now it's connected to the TV, so we'll try that in a minute. But first of all, it's also connected to my Amazon Music, so I'm gonna try playing a tune on that so you can hear what it sounds like. And there are settings in the app, like, that allows you to change it for dialogue mode and switch the bass around and stuff, but I can't do that while I'm also filming with my phone. Okay, so that's pretty good. Using this little thing, you can also use the app. You can control everything with the app, but it does give you a little remote control, which is easier when I'm using my phone. So the next thing to do is to try it with something on the TV. It's the middle of the afternoon and there's nothing on the TV, obviously. So I've put in a video so that we can try the sound. This is an episode of Firefly. Discovered one more slightly annoying thing is that because I was playing music on it before, it's not automatically playing the TV sound through the soundbar. It's just playing through the normal speakers on the TV. So I'll play that just now and you can hear it, and then hopefully we'll be able to switch over and hear the difference. Right, let's try it with the other one. Well, I got the soundbar to work, but I had to go into the settings and choose auto wake for optical cables. Apparently, if it was HDMI, it would just have done it by itself, but otherwise, with the optical cable, you have to go in and set it so that it'll realize that it's connected to the TV and the TV is trying to use it. Having done that, you can probably hear the difference now.
Stronger locks, thicker doors, keep everybody where they're supposed to be. Don't even need more rations.
Okay, the dialogue sounded a little bit weird. I mean, there's kind of more bass and there's definitely more volume available, but the dialogue did sound a bit weird. I may fiddle with the settings and try that again. Well, I fiddled about it a bit. I think the dialogue still sounds kind of weird and distorted, but it's a bit better, see what you think. Yeah, so far very good for music, not as good for TV. I think it might take a bit of adjustment to get it so it doesn't sound weird. Okay, a small update. The reason it was getting distorted is because the sound was coming out of the TV and out of the soundbar, and they were sort of in conflict. So now that I have it on mute, the TV on mute that is, and the soundbar not, you should be able to hear a big difference.
Planets need labor, terraforming crews got a prodigious death rate.
Labor, you mean slaves?
Well, I wasn't falling.
Yeah, so that's good. The only thing is that then I've got this mute sign floating around on the TV, which is annoying. I can take that off and just set it at one, like set the volume on the TV at one, which is not too bad. But I think it's still very slightly distorted.
Here's for damn sure.
Is that why you didn't have to lay in more rations?
So I'm probably going to have to do a bit of research online about if there's a way of overcoming that, because I've never used an optical cable before and I think that's the issue. It never happens with the HDMI, I don't think. Anyway, at least I've got over the problem with the distorted speech, so that's good. There's a workaround. And there's probably a better solution as well, but that's where I've got up to for now, and I'm fairly sick of playing around with cables after all that, so I'm just going to leave it there.